Hello friends, welcome in Pharmaceutical Chemistry 2 subject. Our topic is Anti-Malarial Drugs. Myself Mrs. Urmila Ravindra Gaul, lecturer in KK Wagh Institute of Pharmacy, Chandori. And this is part 1 for Anti-Malarial Drugs. First of all, we see what is the learning outcome. After watching this video, student will able to know the name or anti-malarial drug according to their IUPAC system, to understand life cycle of malaria, to understand the mechanism of action of anti-malarial drugs, to classify anti-malarial drugs, and to recognize the anti-malarial drug according to their structure and physical property. First of all, we see what is malaria. Malaria is an acute infectious disease mainly transmitted by female Anopheles mosquito, a disease caused by Plasmodium parasites and transmitted by a bite of infected mosquitoes. Causative agent, Plasmodium species. The protozoan parasites. Mainly four species infecting human. These are Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium malariae, and Plasmodium ovale. And it is characterized by chills, high fever, anemia, and sweating. Type of malaria. Plasmodium falciparum, it is the most dangerous species and causes an acute rapidly fumigating disease that is characterized by persistent high fever, orthostatic hypotension, and massive erythrocytosis, capillary obstruction, and death if treatment is delayed. In Plasmodium vivax, it is caused a milder form of disease, and Plasmodium malariae, it is common to most tropical regions, and Plasmodium ovale, it is rarely encountered. Life cycle of malaria. It involves hepatic pre-erythrocytic stage. It contains parasite localized in liver and patient is asymptomatic. Second stage, erythrocytic stage. That means it happens in RBC. Parasites invade RBC. Patient develops fever cycle. And last cycle is development of sexual forms that involves occur in Anopheles mosquitoes. Life cycle of malaria. First of all, malaria parasites spread by successive infecting mosquitoes, that is Anopheles mosquito, and whenever infected mosquito bites to healthy person, it spread sporozoites in their bloodstream. Then the sporozoites are rapidly taken by the liver cell. These parasites develop from schizonts, form the several thousand merozoites. Only a portion of liver stage parasites known as hypnozoites remain dormant in hepatocytes. In this stage, the parasites can remain dormant for months or several years. These two species of parasite can therefore initiate a cycle of asexual reproduction, causing clinical symptoms in the absence of new mosquito bites. When the liver cell ruptures, the merozoites are released into bloodstream where they rapidly invade the RBC, that is red blood cell. These blood stage parasites replicate asexually and rapidly attaining a high parasite burden and destroying each RBC cell. And after destroying RBC, the मेरोजाइट्स आर कन्वर्टेड इनटू ट्रोपोजाइट्स. द ट्रिगर इज एट एट अननोन, बट द स्मॉल परसेंटेज ऑफ दिस मेरोजाइट्स डिफरेंशिएटेड इनटू मेल गैमेट एंड फीमेल गैमेट, वेयर दीज आर टेकन बाय मॉस्किटो इन हर ब्लड मिल एंड इट इज गैमेटोसाइट्स दैट कॉजेज द साइकिल ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन टू कंटिन्यू बैक टू द मॉस्किटो. मेल एंड फीमेल गैमेटोसाइट्स फ्यूज टूगेदर टू फॉर्म न्यू स्पोरोजॉइट्स विद इन द मॉस्किटो गट एंड दैट आर डिप्लॉयड जाइगोट्स एंड विच टर्न बिकम ओकाइनेट्स. दीज ओकाइनेट्स माइग्रेट टू द मिड गट ऑफ इंसेक्ट, पास थ्रू द गट वॉल एंड फॉर्म्स ओसाइट्स. माइटोटिक डिविजन ऑफ ओसाइट्स ऑकर्स एंड स्पोरोजॉइट्स आर फॉर्म which then migrate to salivary gland of female Anopheles mosquito and ready to continue the cycle of transmission back to male. Then this again infected female mosquito again binds to healthy person and inject that sporozoites to bloodstream, and then this cycle is continued. Then what is anti-malarial drug? Anti-malarial drugs, these are the type of anti-parasitic chemical agent often naturally derived and that can be used to treat or prevent malaria. In short, to prevent or treat malaria, the drugs which are used are called anti-malarial drugs. Then classification of anti-malarial drugs. First, depending upon their site of action, these are divided into sporonticidal, that is also called sporontocidals. These are effective on sporozoites. For example, pyrimethamine. Second class, tissue seizonticides. These are effective at pre-erythrocytic stage, that is in liver. For example, primaquine, provoquin, and pyrimethamine. And third class is blood seizonticides. These are effective at erythrocytic stage, means in RBC, and these are divided into fast-acting seizonticides, for example, quinoline, chloroquine, and amodiaquine. And second subtype is slow-acting seizonticides, for example, provoquin and pyrimethamine. Fourth class is gametocytes, and these are effective on gametes. Example, primaquine and quinoline. Second classification depends upon chemical. These are divided into first quinoline derivative, and these are again divided in alkaloids, for example quinoline. Then second, 4-aminoquinolines, for example chloroquine and amidioquine. 8-aminoquinoline, for example primaquine. Second class, acridine derivatives, and the example is mipecrine. Third class, bigonides, for example provoquin. Fourth class, pyrimidine derivative or diaminopyrimidine, example pyrimethamine and trimethoprim. Fifth class, miscellaneous class, and example is sulfonamide, for example prontosil, and sulfone, for example dapsone. Now we see what is the drug which are used in malaria. First, tissue seizonticides, the drug eliminating developing or dormant liver forms. Means these drugs are mainly effective in liver. Second, blood seizonticides, drug acting on erythrocytic parasites. When these seizonticides are enter in RBC, at that time blood seizonticides are effective. Gametocytes, drug that kills sexual stage and prevent transmission to mosquito. When gametes are produced, that is female gamete and male gamete, at that stage these gametocytes kills that gametes and prevent transmission to mosquitoes. Next part will be seen in next part. Thank you.